Hola, community. I'm Pablo Vasquez, and over 2 years ago, in one of these update videos, I got to share the moment where Blender 2.8 went public. It's always been public, it's an open source project, of course, but the moment where people could try the alpha release. It was a very special day, and I think today is just as special because, since 1 hour ago, the Everything Nodes project, or like the Geometry Nodes, which is one subset of that big project, has been merged in Master, which means it's now available for download in the regular Blender, the one that is going to become Blender 2.92 in February next year. So, what is it and why are we here? Okay. Everything Nodes is a project that is a very ambitious name that everything in Blender eventually at some point should be or should have an option to be node-based, bringing a lot more flexibility and just opening the horizons of what can be done in Blender. So far we have the compositor, the node, the shader nodes, texture editing, which is barely there, but there are some areas that Blender uses nodes for already. And the step that we're going to see today is that modifiers can be nodal. So yes, modifiers, there's just one modifier at the moment, which is node-based, but all the other ones eventually are going to become one, two, or most of them. The ones that make sense. In code.blender.org, you're going to see the blog where we celebrate this. There's a nice blog post by Dalai Felinto and an image, which if you click, you're going to get to download the sample file. You can read a little bit more about the motivation, about the notes that are there. Remember, these are the very, very basic one. This is the approach of developing this project was, okay, let's get the very basics first and publish it and just sharing it with the world. Not like make the whole system and then publish, but just, okay, we have five nodes. Yeah, okay, people, here are five nodes. This is what you can do with that, with it. And there's an example file. So there are two example files here you can download. This one up here, which I actually have right here. And so how does it work? How does it work? Well, if you just start from scratch, you will find that there is a new, let me get rid of myself here, that if you add a new modifier, you're gonna find geometry nodes. Once you add this one, you're gonna see, hey, there is a node, geometry nodes, and there is a new editor that you're gonna find here, geometry node editor. There's still no workspace dedicated for it, but as you can see, there is something that happens. And also you're gonna find that this node is now has a blue outline. This is a new concept of active nodes. It means that this node is active. So if I choose, I don't know, bevel, now this one is active and I don't have any node here because the modifier still doesn't support any nodes, but eventually it will. So if I select the geometry nodes, I see it here. Okay, what can I do with it? Well, many things. You can shift A to add attributes, colors, geometry, and so many more. Not so many, actually, I should say many, but some basics ones you are going to be familiar with, like math or Boolean math, or that one is new. But for example, we can add a subdivision surface. So we have subsurf in the node, and we can add some transforming, geometry transform. And then you can perform many changes here from the UI. You can also expose very quickly. You can expose like the integer, the level. You're gonna find that there's new colors here also for the sockets. This green means that it's an integer. This color means that it's a Boolean. So it means it's either on or off. This color is geometry. It matches the color here in the outliner, the same as the node. And there's also other new ones for attributes, which is this light blueish color. You're gonna have so much fun to play with it here. You can expose these values. You can change it up here. If you open the file that it's already shared, you're gonna see a real setup. You're gonna see that Okay, this is the group input. This is what is actually being exposed in the node itself. So you can, for example, here manage how many pebbles in the large area, in the middle, so medium pebbles and the small ones. So you can control the density. Let's go through it a little bit, not too much, because there's actually a lot of material online. So yeah, object info. This is object ground new. This is the object. If we go to the outliner, you're gonna see that this object is actually a mesh. This is where we're going to use to put the pebbles on. But the pebbles themselves are actually from this point cloud object that is pebbles. So if you shift A, you can add a point cloud object. At the moment, this is a limitation, but this works better for like point distribution to do this in a point cloud object, but eventually this will be also for regular mesh objects. Just keep that in mind. At the beginning, this is how it works. So pebbles, you add a pebble scattering modifier or a geometry nodes modifier, and you have object info. You take the geometry and then you distribute the points using the density of the large pebble. So these are the large ones. Then you have a few random attributes. So you have a type float in this case, and then the scale. So where is the scale? This scale is an internal value, like an internal attribute of the mesh of the particles. Then you have a minimum, maximum, and a seed. And the same for the rotation. Rotation is a vector, so this is the randomness. So it's actually not really random. Minimum, maximum is the same. It's minimum and maximum. So there's quite a range up here. 3.14. Point instance the object. That is the object that you want to make a copy of. Then you join the geometry and join again. In the past few weeks, people have been using the Boolean. There is also a Boolean node. Oh, there is Boolean node here, which works, but it's much slower because it's actually trying to make a Boolean, a Boolean. This join geometry came to the rescue, so it's much faster. It doesn't have to calculate anything, just joins the geometries, like in this case, the point instance of the pebble, and then the other type of pebble and the other type, all three of them. Then they get joined, and this is their result. So it's it looks more complex than it actually is. It's just three times. If you just want one kind of pebbles, you will have like only one kind. And this is using two types of randomness, one for the scale and one for the rotation. But you can also have like, for example, density attribute. What is this? Well, this is a vertex group that you have in the mesh. So if you go to vertex group, you're gonna find that there's three vertex groups, and if we just see it here as a solid or wireframe, we see that this is one and these are the other ones. So this is how you call the attributes. You just call them by their name here. Okay, I think that is enough for just browsing the file. If you want to learn more, go to YouTube. You are on YouTube probably already. This Blender geometry nodes, search for this and you're gonna find videos from even 3 weeks ago, but I bet if you just filter for like this week, people having, yeah, look at that. Procedural chair tutorial with geometry nodes. Then geometry nodes, procedural abstract render. Then geometric, and okay, this is old from November, but geometry nodes. So just look for it and you're gonna find so much content already. The thing is not even released, but people have been creating amazing things. Here Miro has been creating great things here. I'll go to DevTalk also to give feedback about the project on devtalk.blender.org. You're gonna find the geometry nodes thread where you're gonna see the project and give some feedback. I hope you enjoy this and go have fun. Go to builder.blender.org or blender.org/experimental and download master. It's in master. Yes. Yeah. It's gonna be in 2.82. Isn't that great? See you until the next video. Bye bye.